You thought it was going to be Josh, those, you know, not be able to play those two Sundays.
Is it different?
Yeah, been even maybe more impactful than you thought, or whatever.
It was just as impactful as I thought it would be. You know, it was a huge hurt for me to not be able to play from the beginning. You know, so when it actually did, you know, transpire, I was just as upset as I was the first time I found out about it.
Did any of those kids know you were suspended?
They did. They did.
Were they rough on you?
No, not at all.
No.
Not at all. They're just happy to see me, you know. So we try to even step away from the football aspect of things and just focus on them.
Oh. How about around town, like when you see people at Greed Lunch or something? Is it tough to have fans say, you know, talk to you about the suspension or that stuff? Did you get any grief on it?
I wouldn't say too much, not really. I didn't even really try to go out too much. You know, I stayed home, stayed here quite often throughout the week and everything like that. But when I did see some people recognized me and everything, they were pretty encouraging for the most part, you know. People have, you know, certain choice words. I haven't really heard any.
Hey, you're friends with Greg Little, obviously. Mm-hmm. What's going on with him on the field, do you think? I mean, he's had two rough games.
I'm not really sure. You know, he's definitely a great wide receiver. He's got a great work ethic and doing everything he could possibly do to help his team win. And it was probably just a rough game for him, like you said, just something you have to overcome and persevere through. And he'll be back and with his old self playing good, making big plays.
Josh, you know, you talk about, you know, making the adjustments to not make mistakes. Yet we haven't talked to you about, you had that speeding ticket. I think you were going 98 or something like that. What? How does that happen? You try and put out a new image.
I mean, when stuff like that happens, you know, I mean, get speeding tickets, you speed a little too much, you know, it's just something I have to deal with and something, a mistake I made that I definitely shouldn't ever do again.
I mean, 98 miles an hour, that's not just, you know, it's inching over.
It's a little hard to, you know, to gauge the speed. It might jump from 70 to 80 to 90 sometimes in a faster car, drive a pretty fast car, another line.
Hey,
regarding, you know, that situation, do you feel like, you know, that and the suspension and all those things rolled into one have helped you kind of turn over a new leaf a little bit and kind of get it all together?
It definitely has. You know, like I said before, just being taken away from it, you know, it's a humbling experience for me, you know, and to just find an appreciation for the game, you know, the absence of it makes your heart grow fonder in a sense, you know, so that's really what it's about for right now. So,
I think you kind of were alluding to this earlier, but you feel like you're done with your last fight with these guys.
With Cleveland,
yeah.
I mean, I feel like it's a last chance opportunity for, you know, for the league. You know what I'm saying? Nobody just wants to call them, you know, problematic type of person on their program, on the organization because of how it perceives to be. You know, so I definitely want to stay away from any controversy, because, you know, as long as I can forever. You know, so that's definitely my number one priority.
Is anyone particular or anyone of meaning has sat down and had a heart to heart with you regarding that? What you stand to lose here?
Yeah, I mean, mostly it's just me. I talk to my family, you know, my brothers. I confide in my brothers, my mother, you know, a lot. You know, it hurts them just as much as it hurts me. They want to see the best come out of me. And they know what I'm capable of, and possibly I can, you know. But so when I upset them and I let them down, you know, it impacts me a lot harder than probably somebody else talking to me about.
Josh, just, you know, I think last year Mike Holmgren, Eckert and those guys, and Pat Shermer, they were really kind of got on you to stay, you know, on the straight and narrow. Do you miss that guidance?
I feel as though the guidance is really put on myself at this point. You know, nobody should be a, you know, a caretaker for me at this point in my life. You know, be seen as a grown man and have the responsibility for the actions I'm taking. You know, and I have to look at it that way. I can't really just expect to have somebody there for me to always be in my ear to tell me to do this and do that. You just got to know right from wrong.
Beyond the league point, which you spoke out pretty well as far as your chances, do you have to regain trust in this locker room for these guys, because they depend on you knowing what kind of playmaker you can be? Can they trust you?
I hope that the trust is still there from before, but I mean, it's something I'm definitely going to have to earn back up, you know, making plays and just, you know, showing how hard I can go out there and practice during the game, you know, being committed to it, you know, as a whole, not myself, but just everybody, we need trust together, you know, so it's a big commitment thing for me, and and they have to see that in me.
How happy are you to have this behind you to be able to talk football now?
I mean, it's a big deal. You know, I know it was a looming, you know, type cloud just behind me, some negativity. So I'm glad to be back on, you know, back on the field, and hopefully more people can focus on that.
Hey, Josh, has Jim Brown talked to you about any off-the-field issues?
He has not. He has not. Jim's a great guy. I talked with him a few times, but we haven't talked about anything in person like this.
And as far as football, I know you said that, you know, we'd be shocked to see how much you guys are going to be running down the field in this offense. We haven't really seen, you know, a ton so far. Do you think you're the missing link in the vertical downfield part of the passing game?
Like I said before, I can't just say to myself anything like that. I definitely want to go out there and help, you know, any way I can to go 100%. You know, at this point, you know, the guys just struggled through these last two games, and it's early in the season. It's a long season, and I definitely think the rhythm will get there and it'll get some clicking, you know, with or without me, you know what I'm saying, being the reason why. But I think it's just one of those things you have to regroup and learn and just go back and see what happened wrong to get the new things right, you know.
Have you studied?
Let's give him a couple more guys.
Have you studied the Minnesota tape a little more coming up? Sorry.
Yeah, no, you're fine.
Have you studied the Minnesota tape a little more since you know this was your first game coming up?
I had a chance to look at it, you know, but for the most part, I've been studying with these guys. I've been studying, you know, so I got about just as much opportunity to look at it early as they did going home on my iPad and stuff like that, you know. So, but in here, I study what they study week by week. But I did get to see him. I watched the game and did get to see a little bit of the film I did.
Josh, are you at the point where you would face that year-long banishment with the next fail or the next violation of the substance abuse policy?
Am I?
Are you at the point where the next thing would be year banishment?
I think that's what it is. I believe so.